When I found out that I was scammed, I felt real upset and I cried. I've never cried over money, but it was pretty upsetting.
I'd like to think that I'm not someone that would be easily tricked. I think most people would hopefully not think that.
I like to think I'm not gullible, not easily tricked.
I'd consider myself quite onto it on the computer and online. I got scammed when I was 17. I had saved up 9 months to move over to Berlin, and I was online looking at apartments and I found the perfect apartment, 2 bedrooms, was going to move in with my friend, contacted the landlord, they sent through their passport, they sent through a lease, I spoke to them over the phone, and then I transferred them the bond and first 2 weeks' rent, which was over $2,000, and then I never heard back from them.
So the way I got scammed was I originally was trying to sell a car a few years ago. We had a few people come through and inquire about it and started conversing back and forth via email. And then somebody said, yep, we're really happy, we want to buy it. I was like, that's awesome. They said that they're not in the country at the moment. And so that they wanted to do it via check. And we're like, that's fine, we don't have a problem with that. So they sent us a check and they come back with, oh, well, actually we want you to help us and we want you to be able to ship it overseas for us. And so that'll help pay for the shipping costs. I was like, yep, sure, no worries. So we got the check, it was an overseas one. And so I went back and asked the cashier, I was like, so how long do checks take to clear? And she goes, oh, for New Zealand checks, it's 7 days, so no worries. But anything overseas, it's about 6 months. So you can have the money, but then they can still take it out after 6 months. So at that point, I canceled the check, told them to take it back, and then we emailed them back and said, hey, if you want to carry on with this, we just need to do the transaction another way. And they came back and said nothing, absolutely nothing. So yeah, that was the fun part.
I was out with some of my friends. We were organizing to get back into town. I was like, cool, I'll order the taxi. And then my app wouldn't work. A couple of days later, I was looking at my bank statement and went through all of my transactions, and there were all of these like huge bills. There were charges that I didn't recognize, but had been incurred in Russia. And I was like, well, I would love to go to Russia, but that is not, those are not mine. So I tried to get in touch with the ride sharing app to be like, hey, what are these transactions for? I couldn't get into my account. I looked into similar stories and it looks like it's actually quite a common thing. If you've used the same password for multiple accounts, that meant that someone was able to hack my account. Unfortunately, there are some really horrible people out there that take advantage of people who might not have as great technology skills, but honestly, I think anyone can be scammed.
It's not about having a typical person at all. Anybody can get scammed from somebody that's just unaware of anything or uninitiated online or even just walking along the street. It's pretty easy.
I would never have expected to be scammed, but I was. Same with my parents and my brother. They were all shocked about the situation. And I would look up tools to help prevent that happening.
Lots of places you can go and find out the information, either simple Googling for scams and whatnot. BNZ has the Scam Savvy tool, which is quite good to be able to use to find out about recent scams that are out there and how they work and how to avoid them and how to check up.
And they've also got a couple of tests and games where you can test yourself on some common scams or some common tricks that scammers use. So that's been really helpful to remind me every time I get an email to look out for spelling mistakes, or like, was I expecting this text or email, or kind of familiarizing yourself with tricks that other scammers use so that you can just do what you can to protect yourself, really.
Scam saving means just being aware, being actually knowing what's out there, how to find out about scams, just basically checking, because it can change so quickly in this world with everything from the phones to emails to just, you can get scammed in so many different ways. It's no longer just somebody that you meet on the street anymore.
I'm very careful now. I make sure that I have a contract for everything. I make sure that I meet people in person before signing anything, and I make sure that I have all of their contact details in case something were to go wrong, and I make sure that we have a mutual agreement before something goes wrong.
Being scammed has made me a little more cynical, I guess. Like, it's annoying, and that I'm just less trusting, which is probably a good thing, but you know, you want to believe in people and you want to believe that there's good things going along.
I like to think that people are pretty honest with what they do and how they do it, but try to investigate a little bit more rather than just take people at face value. Oh, it most definitely was too good to be true.